Hi, it's Graham C from Sowing Seeds Ministries. We're going to do a mini series from Romans 8, 28 to 30. The title being God Works for Good in All Things. So I'm just going to read the scripture, Romans 8, 28 to 30. And we know that in all things God works for good of those who love him. We have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. I just want to say to you today that God's plans for you and for me are bigger than our problems. You know, have you ever felt that you've been pinned to the mat and you can't get away, you just cannot get up, you cannot get, and you just think, what's the point? I want to give up. I just want to surrender and do nothing with my life. God's not with me. God doesn't love me. Well, I want to help you to see with a different eye. God is for you, and his plans are much bigger than your mind is telling you. Your mind is telling you that you can't do it, you'll never achieve it, you're not good enough. How can I do it? I've got no education. I've even had people say to me, how can I come into the prison or the school with you? I haven't got a testimony like you. You don't need a testimony like me or like someone else. I haven't got one like David Hamilton's, but it was his testimony that helped me to get to know Jesus. And listen, we, as long as we care enough, God will use you in every situation. So when we're suffering through difficult times, we can know that God will cause the bad situation to work together for good. We've got to believe that. I watched this morning a footballer, foreign footballer's, Italian or Spanish footballer's daughter jumping onto a box, trying to jump on a box. And this girl must have been 5 or 6, and she kept falling off it and falling off it and falling off it. And in the video, you see a dad coming and tell her something, and she keeps going, and then she does it. But she didn't quit, she didn't give up. And you might be yourself thinking that you've fallen off that box, you can't achieve it, you can't get over the hurdles that you're going through. But you've got to let the Lord help you. So today and forever, when you come to an obstacle, when you come to something that you think is going to stop you moving forward or having the best life, you've got to look at it, that challenge, and say, God, help me with it. Help me with it. You might be doing something. You might be going through something that you quitting will weaken you, not strengthen you. You know, we go through many trials and tribulations, and then trials are to strengthen us. You know, if I went to the gym on Monday, or a Tuesday, or a Wednesday, and the next day I woke up in pain, and I didn't go again the day after, and I waited another month, then I'd have to start again. Listen, the key is, when you're going through issues, when you're going through problems, you know, we all do it, we all go through these issues and these problems. When you're going through them, look to Jesus and ask him if he'll help you, if he'll work with you in that situation and grow you, rather than throwing the towel in. You've got to keep going, you've got to keep going, you've got to keep going. And ask God to come and help you to look at that problem with a different light and a different eye. So today's message is that problem could become your strength, it could become your lifesaver. Don't give up, just keep going forward. Tomorrow we're going to talk about not being ashamed of the issues we have, but rejoicing that they're awesome. So let's pray. I want to pray for you. If you don't know Jesus, this is a prayer for you to get to know Jesus. I do this after every message, and you know why, because that's my aim, is to tell you to ask Jesus to come into your life and to help you go forward. So the prayer goes like this, just follow me. Dear Lord Jesus, I acknowledge now that you died on a cross for my sins. I ask you, Jesus, to come into my life and forgive my sins and help me to go forward in Jesus' name. Amen. See you guys. I'll see you next session. God bless. Love, Graham.